This is a Red FM podcast.
ਸ਼ਾਮਲ ਹੋ ਰਹੇ ਹਨ ਸੋਨੀਆ ਫਰੈਸਨਿਓ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਗ੍ਰੀਨ ਪਾਰਟੀ ਦੇ ਨਵੇਂ ਲੀਡਰ ਬਣੇ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਕਾਉਚਨ ਵੈਲੀ ਤੋਂ MLA ਹਨ ਅਤੇ ਉਹ 2428 ਵੋਟਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਜਿੱਤੇ ਸਨ ਅਤੇ ਹੁਣ ਉਹ ਐਂਡਰਿਊ ਵੀਵਰ ਦੀ ਥਾਂ ਲੈ ਲੈਣਗੇ ਗ੍ਰੀਨ ਪਾਰਟੀ ਹੈ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਉਸ ਦੀਆਂ 3 ਸੀਟਾਂ ਨੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ 2017 ਦੀ BC ਦੀ ਇਲੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਹ ਸੀਟਾਂ ਜਿੱਤੀਆਂ ਸਨ ਪਰ ਸੀਟਾਂ ਜਿੱਤਣ ਤੋਂ ਪਿੱਛੋਂ ਜਦੋਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਸਪੋਰਟ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕੌਨਫੀਡੈਂਸ ਐਂਡ ਸਪਲਾਈ ਅਗਰੀਮੈਂਟ ਲਿਖ ਲਿਆ ਸੀ ਇਹ ਅਗਰੀਮੈਂਟ ਕੀ ਹੈ ਜਿਹਦਾ ਵਾਰ ਵਾਰ ਜ਼ਿਕਰ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ ਹੈ ਤੇ ਨਵੇਂ ਲੀਡਰ ਸੋਨੀਆ ਫਰੈਸਨਿਓ ਕੀ ਸਮਝਦੇ ਹਨ ਸਾਡੇ ਨਾਲ ਸ਼ਾਮਲ ਹੋ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਸੋਨੀਆ ਫਰੈਸਨਿਓ ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਵੈਰੀ ਮੱਚ ਫਾਰ ਜੁਆਇਨਿੰਗ ਅਸ
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਵੈਰੀ ਹੈਪੀ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਹੇਅਰ
Congratulations on becoming the BC Green Party leader. How are you feeling today?
Terrific, thank you. Very excited and very grateful to the amazing campaign team and the incredible hardworking volunteers who really made this happen. I'm so grateful.
So what is your vision for the party now?
So we need to focus on people, what matters in people's day-to-day lives right now. And there is a lot of challenges. There's a lot of anxieties. We're in a global pandemic, the COVID numbers are rising. Kids have gone back to school. Families are facing anxiety and uncertainty about that. Teachers are very anxious. And we really need to focus on ensuring that the people of British Columbia feel like their government is working in their best interest and working to help make sure that they can feel more security about their finances, about their housing, about their communities, about the sustainable economy that we need to build, and about the future for their children.
You have been elected the leader of this Green Party when this Green Party's support is very, very important to the ruling NDP. And now your previous leader has signed a confidence and supply agreement. I think you are also a signatory to it. So is it still valid? Now we are hearing about the election coming in, and your supply agreement says otherwise. What are your views on this?
Well, I made my views very clear yesterday, which is at a time like this, when we are in two health crises, we have two overlapping health emergencies. We have air that is choking us from the fires in the Western United States. We have kids back in school and all of the anxieties and concerns related to that. Right now, John Horgan has a responsibility to govern and to focus on the people of British Columbia and to make sure that he and his government are working with the provincial health officer to make sure that the health and safety of people of this province are first and foremost. There is no reason for him to call an unnecessary election. The confidence and supply agreement has delivered a stable government for 3 years. And it is very capable of continuing to do that. We just passed a budget in the House in this last session. I'm calling on John Horgan not to take an unnecessary risk by calling an unnecessary election right now.
But Premier Horgan is shifting a bit. Premier Horgan has said that today's Green Party is a completely different party than when the agreement was signed. So what does he really mean about it? What do you think?
We're not a completely different party. We are the same party that signed that agreement that has been working with government to deliver extraordinary outcomes for the people of British Columbia, more than any government in a very long time. And minority governments are the healthiest form of democracy because they hold government to account in ways that are better for the citizens and for the people of British Columbia. We are the same party. I am a leader that is committed to cooperation and collaboration, and first and foremost, to putting the well-being of people first. And I think he can rise and be the best premier that he can be by also saying, I'm going to put the well-being of people first.
Well, when his popularity is 69%, and all the conditions are really in his favor, it's a political game. I mean, this is a blood sport. What would you do in case he crosses this? What will you do if he doesn't really agree with the supply agreement and he breaks this agreement? What options do you have?
We've just come through this leadership campaign, which has been incredibly momentum building. We've doubled the number of members we have in the BC Greens. We have teams that are built across the province, and we are ready but we are also saying he shouldn't be doing this. It isn't a game. We're in a global pandemic. It is not a game. People's lives are at risk, and playing politics as a game is not the right thing to do right now. When we look at the governments that have delivered the best outcomes, and BC has been among those, it is the governments that put people first, not politics or their party's fortunes.
No, I fully understand your sentiment. You're saying he should not do it. That's a ethical advice. That's a moral advice. I mean, politically, what can you do? Are you going to sue him?
Nope. We will run the very best campaign that we can, and we will elect extraordinary people who will also continue to hold government to account.
Anything you'd like to say in closing?
Well, I really appreciate the opportunity to speak with you this morning, and I'm very much ready to continue to work very hard on behalf of the people of British Columbia. I am committed to ensuring that people understand that we put their health and well-being, their security. We recognize how people feel right now. There's a lot of anxiety about financial security. A lot of small businesses need to know that they're going to be supported, and that is essential. A lot of parents and families need to know that government is putting them first, and that is also important. And I am here on behalf of the people of BC, and I am in service to them.
Sonia Fresnew, thank you very much for giving your time. We will speak to you again.
Thank you so much.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you for listening to another Red FM podcast. Don't forget to hit subscribe and check out our Red FM Canada YouTube channel. For further info, log on to our Red FM social media platforms or visit redfm.ca.